Hey guys, I'm Deepankar from Techlomedia, and this phone is Alcatel One Touch Flash 2. It is perfect in hand, offers good design, good hardware specifications, and claims to have very good camera. It is priced at ₹9,299. It will be available via Flipkart from flash sales. So you need to first register and then wait for the flash sales. If I talk about the design of the smartphone, design of this phone is very good. It has a 5-inch of display. At the top, it has a 5-megapixel front camera with front LED flash. Below side, there are three touch buttons. Only one is visible and two are not visible, but those buttons are there. Even after turning the screen on, you cannot see the touch buttons. Below side, it has a micro USB port and a microphone. At the back side, it has a 13-megapixel rear camera with True Tone LED flash. There is also a flash branding, you can see that. And below side, you can see Alcatel One Touch branding and speakers. Back cover is rough and has matte finish, which looks very good. At the right side of this device, there is a power button, volume rocker keys, and there is a dedicated camera shutter button. You can see it from the close. This is the camera shutter button. So just press this button to open the camera or to capture the photos from the rear camera or front camera. 3.5mm audio output jack at the top side of this device. It has mark-free curved back to keep your device spotless and dirt-free all the time. And seriously, it looks very good in hand and offers better grip. Due to the rough surface, you can easily hold in hand and it will not slip easily. Back panel of this device is removable, which houses 3000 mAh battery with smart power saving mode. It claims to offer 10 hours of talk time. There are also two SIM card slots and one slot for micro SD. Both SIM cards supports 4G LTE. It has 5-inch of HD IPS display with 178-degree viewing angles. And seriously, viewing angles seems to be very good of this device. Display has 294 ppi pixel density. Display is powered by Myra Vision technology, which seems to offer the good color reproduction. And the sharpness of this display is also very good, so you will enjoy full HD videos and gaming on the display of this device. It has 64-bit octa-core MediaTek MT6753 processor with 2GB LPDDR3 SDRAM. It seems to offer robust performance and good multitasking. Mali T720 MP4 GPU also offers good graphics processing. So overall, multitasking of this device seems to be very good. I can easily switch from one app to other app and quickly open or close the apps. So overall performance seems to be very good in the first impression. Now let me check more in the settings, the about menu. In the about section, you can see the model number and other technical details. It runs on Android 5.1 Lollipop. You can see the Lollipop logo on the screen right now. Let me just check the storage status. This is a demo unit, and around 10.5 GB is available for users. Few apps have been installed. It also supports SD card slot to expand the storage up to 128 GB. It also supports USB OTG, so you can access data directly from pen drive. It also supports smart awake, that means double tap to wake up the screen. There are also many other options in the settings menu which you can try. It has 13-megapixel G-Sight rear camera with 2.0 aperture, fast focus, ISO cell sensor, 80-degree wide angle lens, and real tone flash. So the camera is the main attraction of this phone. Company talks too much about the camera of this device. This is the camera app. Company calls the camera photography of this device as movie-graphy experience. So these are the different modes which you can try to give your photography a better experience. You can also capture panorama from the front camera. You can see there are various modes, and at the top you can also see the option for the settings to customize the photography. The settings for photos and videos, you can configure so many things from the settings. Now let me just check the shutter speed. At the top, you can see the options for going settings. You can also just swipe right to open settings. There are various other options for flash and other things. Let me now check the shutter speed. Flash is on, so it is taking time to capture the photo. Now let me just turn the flash off. Okay, Now as you can see, the shutter speed is very good, so if you are not using the flash, you can quickly capture the photo. The focus of this camera is also very fast. It can focus on object in just 0.3 seconds. And this is the photo which I captured from the rear camera. You can see that the color reproduction, the color capture was very good. Even after zooming this photo, I cannot see the noise in the photo. You can see